Hugh Sheridan.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, we already had Denise doing some shimmies there. The audience is loving it as well. But what is it, Hugh, about Neil Diamond's songs that drew you to them?
Well, I love Neil Diamond, I think, because he's such a brilliant storyteller. You know, he's a songwriter that has all these amazing stories, and everyone has their own unique experience, I think, with his songs. I mean, you know, Denise, right? You might have come home time to time, put on a bit of Solitary Man or Love on the Rocks, poured yourself a scotch on the rocks at the end of the day. But hearing your parents' songs and also my own experience over the last few years of really getting into his music, and his love songs are incredible, like Play Me, and then there's songs that I had no idea what they meant. Like I heard a song called Heart Glow, and I thought that's a beautiful song, and then I found out that it was actually he, Carol Bayer-Sager and Burt Bacharach went and saw E.T. and they were so moved. Yeah. They wrote Heart Glow.
What?
And because his heart glows, and I would have had no idea.
So they're very literal people.
Yeah. And Sweet Caroline, I didn't realise was actually about Caroline Kennedy, and it was after her dad had died and he saw a photo and she's now our ambassador.
Yeah.
But Hot August Night, I thought I might invite her along.
Hot August Night would have to be about the most popular sing-along album ever made, wouldn't it?
Yeah, one in three Australian households had it. So, yeah, did you have a copy?
Yes, and in fact, I and my friend decided we would dance to the beginning, the opening, the big
crunchy
orchestra.
Granola sweet.
You know, yeah, how does it go? And that's how my friend and I moved, and we thought we'd go on a talent show and do that with just leotards on. But there's no good point to this story because we didn't do it.
I wish we had some overlay of that. That would have been brilliant.
But it's so everyone knew that album.
But I was the game on Saturday where you sang, and 50,000 people, not 100,000 like MCG, 50,000 people sang with you, didn't they?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I like to think that there was millions of people singing along. Well, actually, they didn't play Sweet Caroline at home. But there you are. There you are. I did the anthem, but then what Ray's talking about is at quarter time, their big, that's their tradition as well.
They play all the time.
Was to do Sweet Caroline. So I did it. And I like to think that it might have been me that got that one little point.
Oh!
I think I had a hand in that. Sorry, Collingwood.
So when you do the national anthem, we asked Katie earlier.
Yeah.
How do you make it your own?
Well, I mean, people tend to, and I heard Katie talking about her incredible arrangement, but I always like to do a good, clear, clean sing-along anthem where it's very easy and predictable, because I think it is beautiful. I did agree with Katie that I was a little thrown by the one and free when I was learning it. She was just practicing it backstage and she said young and free. I said, no, it's one and free. I said, why don't you just say fun and free? We're fun and free. But so many people text me afterwards and they said, Hugh, you sang one and free. It's young and free.
Yeah.
So I was
people don't know.
So it wouldn't have... Like, I guess it's just people are still learning at the moment that it's changed. But I just think the anthem's so beautiful. And I actually love the second verse. And I think that we should actually incorporate that.
It doesn't need to be longer, Hugh. It doesn't.
The second verse, though, has so many great political, I think, relevance with for those who've come across the seas with boundless plans to share. Mm. And I think that that's important as part of the way that Australia was set up. And we did come, many of us, from across the seas. And it's something to think about when we think about sharing our land.
Well, Hugh, I want to ask you because biopics are pretty cool right now. Do you know what I mean? You've got Elton John, you've got Rocket Man, you've got the Queen movie, Bohemian Rhapsody.
Yeah.
Would you be happy to go in as Neil Diamond?
Oh, 100%.
In like, you know, something like a Hugh August Night. Do you know what I mean? Like something like that.
He kind of played himself, though, in The Jazz Singer. But I was just thinking the other day, no one ever did Barry Gibbs or the Bee Gees. And I'd love to do that.
I mean,
you're just now I've put
you're
it out there.
Yeah, that's what this is.
I shouldn't have said that on TV.
Yeah.
Damn it. No. Well, I mean, the thing about Solitary Man is I'm not actually dressing up as Neil Diamond, as fun as that would be.
Yeah, it would be fun.
I know. Well, I'll go for his essence.
Yeah, OK.
But it's essentially just me up there singing his songs, but with an incredible band. I've got James Black as my musical director, 19-piece, and it's going to be very, very fun. We've got Sydney Opera House, Hamer Hall, playing in Canberra.
Venice.
And I think I'm just going to say it anyway. We're playing in Adelaide as well, but I don't think that's been announced. But yep,
it's exclusive.
It's been announced. Yeah.
But you mentioned generations. I mean, there would be kids of your kids' age at the moment who are in the car with mum and dad, and they're still playing Neil Diamond, aren't they?
Yeah. Well, definitely, Sweet Caroline. But wait until they've come and seen the show. You'll be rolling it out. Everyone will be.
Mate, I'll have a couple of shanties. Good Lord.
Good Lord. I'm going to take you straight back to the chums. I am must say.
This is a sweet gig, but I believe, I'm not saying this gig is sweeter, but I believe you've got a gig in Ibiza coming up. How do I get a gig?
I just did it. Part of the reason I did it was to try and get another show that I created for a festival here last year called Human there next year. So fingers crossed that all happens, and then you can all just come and see me there.
But what did you do in Ibiza?
I was DJing.
I
snuck it in for a wonderful charity called Project Zero, and I used it as an opportunity to sell my show over there, because I think, God, why not?
Have you ever thought just take a break here? You've got so much going on right now.
Well, I feel like if you're performing in Ibiza, you get a bit of both worlds, wouldn't
you? Yeah, it's the best. It's the best.
Let's just do Wednesday to Sundays, shall we?
Yeah.
And then I'll do Neil Diamond Monday to Thursday.
Well, the Solitary Man EP is available now, as are tickets to Hugh's tour. Head to our website for all of the details. Please thank Hugh Sheridan.